Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to another video. Today we're playing the game known as Hollowknight. Actually, it's called Hollowknight. I already failed. Wow. Alright, yeah, but this game ended up being one of my favorite games I ever really played. And you might be asking how I would know that if I'm on the start screen. I haven't even made a save file yet. Well, I already played through the game, and my live commentary didn't record, so I'm going to be commentating in post, not replaying the game. And, you know, at the start, I really didn't know what I was getting myself into. I knew a friend enjoyed the game, but I had no idea that I'd be getting myself ready for one of the best games of my life. Right now. I'm gonna be dramatic. In wilds beyond, they speak your name with reverence and regret. For none could tame or challenge savage souls, yet you the challenge met. Under palest watch you taught we changed, base instincts were redeemed. World you gave to bug and beast as they had never dreamed. From LG for Hallinest by Monomon. Jeez, love that. Love her. Great gal. Ooh, spooky. Spooky. Oh, you might be wondering why there's no sound. That's because while I was making the video, I said my live commentary didn't record, and that's partially true. My live commentary didn't record. What did record was an ear-splitting loud noise. Now, at around later, that disappears, so don't worry. And oh my god, look at him. He's so cute. He's gonna go on to slaughter thousands of bugs, because I control him. And I am a bug murderer. So cute. On you go, little knight. Not quite hollow, though. Not quite hollow. And boom. And I got into one of the best gaming journeys of my life. Look at me, so young. Figuring out the controls, jumping, running up the door, running straight into doors, hitting square. Ripping and tearing my ways through doors. Ugh. Ruthlessly chasing down a bug just trying to escape me. Evil. Evil too. And one weird thing about Hollow Knight is that the longer you hold down the jump button, the higher you'll jump. And I didn't figure that out for until then, basically. So. Wow, these crawlids are just getting no mercy. Ooh, and I also developed my love for money here. And then I, platformed. And this is boring. Boom. But eventually I was able to overcome my troubles. And as you can see, I ascended. And, you know, after that, I sort of, you know, just breezed through the rest of the game, you know, and without any troubles at all, you know. Higher beings, these words a few alone. Obviously, I'm a higher being. Your great strength marks you amongst us. Thank you, I am very strong. And focus your soul, and you can achieve feats of which you can only dream. So, you know, after learning this, I was basically ready for anything, and I easily breezed through the rest of the tutorial. Okay, see, this is a different clip. That was a different clip. That I don't know. So my memory might be a little tainted. Well, after that fiasco, I decided it was time to get out of this area, because it wasn't worth my time, you know. But unfortunately, the floor wanted to keep me here. It's kind of clingy. Well, it says I'm clinging. Apparently, I'm clinging to the floor. And oh no. Oh no, you guys see, this is bad for you because now you're witnessing my great skill and now you're really scared of me. But eventually I managed to make it out of the tutorial area. It was a great feat and I survived on one health out of the tutorial. Oh wow, and I just completely destroyed those random statues. Higher beings, these words are for you alone. Beyond this point, you enter the land of King and Creator. Step across this threshold and obey our laws. Bear witness to the last and only civilization, the eternal kingdom, Hollownest. Sorry, guys. I know that was abrupt, but I had a little lore break there. I was like, that is a big door. Hit the door, man. Come on. It's just like every other door. I don't remember this. Oh, there we go. Okay, all right, yeah. So anyways, I began to knock down the door to Hollownest. And you know, and then I was finished with the game. The game, oh no, the game's not over. Okay. This is where the game really starts though. And excuse me, but I'm gonna have to take a quick little lore break. As I walked across the streets, I came across a quaint little town. According to the text at the top of the screen, it was called Dirtmouth. The Fading Town. I approached an old bug. Perhaps he would tell me more about this place. Hello there, traveler! I'm afraid there's only me left to offer welcome. Our town's fallen quiet, you see? The other residents, they've all disappeared, heading down that well one by one to the caverns below. Used to be there was a great kingdom beneath our town. It's long fell to ruin, yet still drops folks into its depths. Wealth, glory, enlightenment. The darkness seems to promise all things. I'm sure you too seek dreams down there. Your dreams down. Well, watch out. It's sickly air that fills that place. Creatures turn mad, and travelers are robbed of their memory. Bzz. Well, apparently, I was also robbed of my memory because I fe- oh, there we- perhaps dreams aren't such great things after all. Well, I guess I was robbed of my memory because I forgot how to hit X for like 5 seconds there. But I discovered the power of bench. Apparently, sitting down, just completely heals you. That's probably why I'm so healthy and strong, because I'd sit on my chair and play video games all day, and sitting down fully heals you. For your mapping supply needs, come to Zelda and Conifer. Their shop. That will be open soon. Okay, I haven't played in a while. All right. Well, no, I haven't played. Whatever. So I descended into what would eventually be my best game ever. This is where the game really starts, because I'm actually in the place, where the game happens now. I approached some new enemies. The new enemies were not very friendly. However, I was undaunted. I made friends the only way I knew how. By making him a corpse. I'm great at making friends. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise. I mean, you can ask my friends. They're in a graveyard behind my house. I journeyed my way through the caverns, exploring the many depths of Hollownest, massacring young crawlids for no reason. I instantly shied away from the room transition, instead preferring to massacre a crawlid in a tick-tick. And then heading back into the room, and I'm gonna guess I head back. Back. Oh no, I don't. Alright, everyone place your bets on what stupid thing I do in the comments. I'm placing mine. I swear I get better at the game. Oh, no, I don't. I don't. I might not. So, boy. Oh wow, live commentary. Did you guys hear that? I'm shocked and appalled. Oh, hey, you know what? I think Cornifer is here. Oh, yay, I get to know another voice. Hey, my best buddy, Cornifer. Ah, hello there. Come down to explore these beautiful old ruins. Don't mind me. I have a fondness for exploring myself. Getting lost and finding your way again is a pleasure like no other. We're exquisitely lucky, you and I. I'm a cartographer by trade, and I'm working mapping this area right now. Would you like to buy a copy of my work so far? Sorry, I really don't do Cornifer's voice justice. He's a great guy, you know. Come on, man, buy this thing. There we go. There we go. Give him your money. Acquired a map. L1 to use a map. A map can be a useful thing, but it alone won't show you where you are. If you're not the head for directions, I suggest purchasing a compass for my wife, Zelda. She's just now opening a new shop in Dirtmouth, selling all sorts of useful things to wanderers like yourself. She'll even sell some of my old maps from time to time. I pop back to see her whenever I'm finished mapping an area. She's always so excited to see me. Now listen, Cornifer is a great guy, but he's not very good at making maps. Even though that is his profession. I was counting on myself to open up the map there. But no. But yeah, so I mean, like, this game, it's really fun. And I was just sort of like enraptured with exploring the area. And that's sort of what this game is until you get into the late game. It's fun exploring. Oh, I think I figured out that you can look up and down. Oh no. Come on, bud. Buddy, you got this. So, eventually, I was able to make my way across the perilous gap that separated me and boiling acid. Upon my journeys, I encountered a new enemy, a strange one. A white creature with an orange belly. He spat out her own young to assault me. And I was like, "Ha, that's totally not cool, dude, bro. You can't attack me with babies. That's like illegal or something. You're a bad parent." To punish her for being a terrible parent, I brutally murdered her children and then eventually stabbed her. Oh, no, I died. Okay, I didn't. I wasn't expecting that. As I said, this footage is mostly unedited. I didn't say that. I never said that at all. Oh, hey, look, it's Zelda's shop is open. Come to my map, have you? It's really my husband you should be dealing with. But what a surprise, he's headed down below. He'll pop back occasionally. He'll deliver new maps for store. But I do wish he'd spend a little more time up here. I've not much interest in retail myself. Now, let's see. What's here for me to sell? The Wayward Compass, which I couldn't afford. The Quill, which I couldn't afford. I couldn't afford anything. Probably because all my money was with my dead ghost, known as a Shade. I think I was calling it before I knew what it was actually called. Like, after my run-in with Zelda, I made my way to a hut that was locked, completely locked. And I also punched a wall for some odd amount of time. I figured there was a secret there. There was no secret. After that fiasco, I decided to journey back down into the well and find out what other wonders Hallownest was keeping secret from me. This time, I decided that since I had already thoroughly checked out the left, I had not thoroughly checked it out, I would head to the right. And on I went on my journey. And I happened to come across a certain core character, important main character, and a very important place. Best boy, Quirrell. Hello there! How delightful to meet another traveler on these forgotten roads! You're a short one, but you've a strong look about you. Thanks, Quirrell. I'm Quirrell. I have something of an obsession with uncharted places. Oh, then you take corner for each charts places. The ancient kingdom holds many fascinating mysteries, and one of the most intriguing of them is standing right before us. A great stone egg lying in the corpse of an ancient kingdom, and the egg is... Is it warm? It certainly gives off a unique air. Can it be opened? There are strange marks all over it. I do so love a mystery, and who knows what other marvels lie even deeper below us. Well, thanks for the foreshadowing, Quirrell. But yes, Quirrell is, as a matter of fact, best boy. Well, I mean, the best boy we've met so far. I do kind of like Cornifer. But, you know, they have a rivalry, you know? I mean, Cornifer likes to chart places, and Quirrell likes uncharted places. Anyways, making my way out of the Black Temple, I totally did not make a cut. Definitely not. And I ended up meeting another core character. Who is actually one of my favorite, but, she can't be best boy. She's best girl. Oh, bury my mother pale and slight. Bury my... Okay, I can't read that fast. Do you know that one? It's one of my favorites. You can sing something else if you like. You start singing and I'll join in. I bet you have a beautiful singing voice. Oh, I think the knight does too, but they never talk. So, what are you down here for? If you came to get wealthy, just look around you. These mines are still bursting with riches. There's plenty for everyone. Just grab a pick and join in. Oh, bury the knight with her broken nail. I can't read that fast past me. You gotta... Wow. I'm so disappointed in the past me. I think I had vowed not to sing the song. So, after my encounter with Myla, the singing bug... who's also a miner. I made my way up, and I discovered a place that may or may not be important to the story in the future. But yeah, for now, I was sort of couldn't do anything there. So I made my way up and out to explore the rest of the kingdom, and I happened upon an unfortunate happening with a rather large bug. And I was absolutely destroyed. But I am determined. So I journeyed back to fight again. And, well, this time didn't go too hot either. Well, after that, I came back to Elderbug for an inspirational pep talk via death teleportation. Did you visit that temple? A strange building, I've heard, though I'd never dared the journey myself. The braver among us once went out there to pray. Oh my us! Said they felt at peace within the walls. After a while, they stopped going. I wonder what changed. Well, thanks, Elderbug. That was really inspirational and motivational about, bugs, not going to church. They're probably all dead now. Well, with Elderbug's words in mind, I decided to send this guy to church. Closer, the best church than anyone had ever seen. Because this church wasn't actually church, he got to literally meet Jesus in the flesh. I killed him. Well, after that, I freed a grub from its jar, and it's very unthankful. So I decided I'd had enough with the unthankful rite, and I started to head left. Through Hollow Nest. And on my journey left, I ended up finding where the little grub had gone. Now, it turned out he had been kidnapped and was being held captive in the jar, and it also looks like there were like a bunch of other places where grubs were. Anyways, his dad was glad I saved him, so he threw me like a lot of money. And I mean like a lot of money. No, just kidding. He threw me like almost no money for saving his only child from certain death. Oh, wait, not only child. From saving a child from certain death. Now, this grub guy is kind of a cheapskate, so I think I'm just, gonna let his children die. After my annoying encounter with the Grubfather, not to be confused with the Godfather. I don't think he's part of any mafia. I, you know, decided to get technologically advanced and unlock some railways. So I journeyed through the rest of, through the Forgotten Crossroads. And I, I eventually arrived at this place, a toll machine with the symbol of a stag, insert Geo. And I decided to do so. Best decision of my entire life. Really. Really it is. Now, at first I thought I would traverse the fast channel tunnels myself. But no. Then I thought it was a boss. But also no. It was a train that was a living creature. Greetings, little one. It's been an age since I last heard the ringing of a station bell. I've grown stiff and tired over these many years, and I've forgotten much. But the sound of the bell will always call me back. I don't like this voice. I need a better voice. These stagways stretch the depths of Hellenist. If you want to travel them, hail me from the platform. It will take you where you need to go. And then, for some reason, I didn't go to Dirtmouth, even though I knew that I could just instantly go back to the Forgotten Crossroads. So I ended up not having the Dirtmouth train station unlocked. But if, who needs stag stations, am I right? I'll just walk the journey with my tiny, pathetic legs. So I kept on journeying through a Forgotten Crossroads, and it seems like I've done a lot of journeying and exploring. Because that's kind of what Hollow Knight is. And it's super fun. And then, oh my god, boss! False Knight, I read. Fear gripped my heart because I was terrible at the game. I clenched my nail in between my finger. I don't have fingers. If you look closely, you'd notice the player character doesn't have fingers. The knight held up an onslaught of attacks. Each one seemed to be stronger than the last. However, I learned. The shockwave he created with his mace could easily be leaped. And his leaping jumps and swings could be avoided if I simply ran away. I dipped and dodged and ducked his many attacks. And I seemed to learn that each attack seemed to have its own prelude, a warning. I was able to stagger the knight, and his helmet revealed his true form. Probably why he was called the False Knight. Not very intimidating when you look at him. I began to focus my soul to heal, but all of a sudden I was interrupted. When he swung his mace, and orange balls seemed to descend from the ceiling. I don't know what they are. Another shockwave missed. However, his strategy of jumping into me seemed to work, because he was so obtusely fat. I didn't survive long. He crashed his mace down onto me, reducing me to a shade-id ghost. But I'm resilient, apparently, and addicted. So I cut out 6 attempts and pretended that this was my second attempt, and I ended up beating him. So, well, yeah, you guys can watch this. And, you know, I think my real saving grace here is that I'm just so flawless and excellent at the game. And, you know, I instantly learn on my second attempt of, you know, fighting any boss, actually. What was once his Alan Slush became my, his onslaught of attacks. Turning to my endless raging torrent of swipes with my sharp bladed nail. A shockwave caught me off guard, but that would not stop me, because I had just realized that you could heal while you were fighting him. And it didn't really matter how good I was at the game then. I just sort of healed. Narrowly dodging attacks from his mace and the balls that seemed to fall from the ceiling, I dodged. However, I also happened to notice that he had cracked the floor on which he stood using with his mace. The brainless brute had not realized that his actions were just destroying his. I don't know. I can't do this on the fly. I should write scripts for these things. If you guys didn't, I'm not. This isn't scripted. I just sort of freestyle it. I knew I only had to stagger the beast once more, and he would go into another frenzy of anger and rage that would eventually shatter the ground. Actually, I didn't know this. I didn't even realize the ground was shattered while I was playing. There stood my chance. The beast left exposed was damaged, his soul harvested, and used to heal thyself. The brute finally destroyed himself. With one final attack, he crashed the floor. His helmet opened to reveal his true form. I finally slayed the epic beast of monstrous proportions. The large creature, the morbidly- Oh my god, he's tiny! Still in awe at his tiny size, I picked up the city crest. I didn't know the importance of this object at the time. I also claimed money. Money is fun. But yeah, anyway, so that was our first episode of the playthrough. I decided I'd end it when I beat the boss. What did you guys think of that? It was pretty cool, right? I love this.